Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about death by drywall. Everybody uses drywall in their builds. We don't have it anywhere near any of our build sites, and we have 12 projects going on right now. And one of the arguments against drywall, or for drywall, if you will, is cost, obviously. A 4x8 sheet costs about 10 bucks in most environments, so we don't use it. We use strictly veneered plywood, and we're going to tell you why, and we're going to kind of dispute some of the reasons that people use drywall. I think veneered plywood, most markets, $60 to $80 a sheet, so there's a big cost difference. But let's look at plywood's advantages versus the cost, and we'll see what we can come up with. A lot of the arguments for drywall is, it's a good sound-absorbing material, and it's much better than plywood. Well, that's not true. Okay, this is a myth that people have bought into over the years, and they haven't checked the data. Let's look at the data. Just a half-inch piece of drywall, we all know what absorption coefficients are. You can look at the rate, you can look at the frequency, 125, 250, 500, 1K, 2K, 4K, and you can compare the absorption coefficients. 125, almost the same. 250, plywood's actually a little bit stronger in absorption. 500, pretty close. 1K, 2K, and 4K, there's hardly any difference. So the argument that drywall is a better sound absorption material from 125 to 4K, simply not true, okay? It's another myth people have bought into over time. Don't assume that because everybody is doing it, that it's correct. The reasons behind the fact that they're doing it may not be good reasons at all. They may be doing it because that's what they've read, that's what they heard, that's what they've seen. Resist, obey little, and resist much. I mean, those are the models when it comes to acoustics. Don't do what everybody else does. If you look at your old studios that were built in the 50s and 60s, wood was dominant everywhere, okay? So were 14-foot ceiling heights, which we've lost. So appearance with veneered plywood is off the scale, much better than drywall. So you have the flexibility with the appearance. You can match and coordinate and contrast with decors. And it's a natural material. We always want to stay with natural materials when we're dealing with sound and audio in our rooms. Here's another big advantage between plywood and drywall. It's a layered material. So there's some vibrational energy management tools built right into the product. Most plywoods we use have 10, 12, 14 layers to them. So we know from our examples that we want the room to move less. Well, if we want the room to move less, we build the room with materials that take out that kind of energy that causes the room to move. So a series of layers with plywood, we get an energy sink built into the product. We don't get that with drywall. And the absorption coefficients are about the same. This is going to be a first in a series of where I go after drywall, and I'm going to try to change your thinking on it. Don't just assume that you're going to use drywall. Now, if the cost is a factor, and you don't have budget because it's 6, 7, 8 times more money, but think about it. You're just going to skin the whole room in drywall, or you're going to skin the whole room in veneered plywood. Maybe the cost difference is $1,000 to $1,500 to $200. And ask yourself, would you rather work in a room that's surrounded by natural wood or crushed rock? Okay, there's your real bottom choice. And we're going to do other videos on the sound quality of it. Okay, so we'll talk about that later, but right now, I just wanted to address the thing that I hear all the time. Well, we have to use drywall because it has better sound absorption characteristics than plywood. And you can see from this data that it's not true. Thank you. Thank you for watching our videos. We really appreciate your support. And if you could give us a thumbs up for our Facebook page, that would really be helpful to us. A room form gives us all the information about your room, length, width, height, usage, and we need you to fill that out before you send it in. Those of you that just found us on the internet and are under a time crunch, you can go to the contact section of our website, and there's a book now button so you can book an appointment with us, but make sure I have your room form to go on with it. The ebook series that we have is free. Please subscribe to that. There's exclusive videos in there so you can get an idea of your particular situation, possibly with the videos. And then our forum. We have a forum on our website. There's a lot of forums out there on the internet. Our forum will actually answer your questions and comments, so you'll be dealing directly with me through our forum. So once again, thank you for your support.